For a heterogeneous reaction, A solid equal to 2B gas plus C gas at certain temperature T Kelvin, Kp is equal to 32 into 10 to the power minus 6 atmosphere to the power 3. Calculate the value of total equilibrium pressure for this reaction. Let us solve this question. Solution of the question requires, first of all, the equation of the reaction, A solid giving us 2B gas and C gas. The value of Kp is given to us as Kp equal to 32 into 10 to the power minus 6 atmosphere to the power 3. Suppose we start our work with 1 mole of A solid. In the beginning, B and C were 0. At equilibrium, it becomes A minus X mole. This becomes 2X moles. This becomes X moles. Therefore, total number of moles at equilibrium. Total number of moles of what? Total number of moles of gases. Solid is not going to be in the picture. So total number of moles of gases would be equal to 2x plus x equal to 3x. Let the total equilibrium pressure for this reaction is equal to P atmosphere. Therefore, partial pressures of the gases involved shall be, for B it will be 2P by 3, and for C it will be only P by 3, because partial pressure is mole fraction into total pressure. The mole fraction for B gas will be 2x upon 3x, that is 2 by 3 multiplied by total pressure P. So partial pressure for B is 2P by 3 and partial pressure for C is P by 3. Therefore, Kp will be equal to, as usual, partial pressure of B raised to power 2 into partial pressure of C raised to power 1. So that is 2P by 3 whole square into P by 3. And that's equal to 4P cube upon 27. We have already noted that Kp is given to us as 32 into 10 to the power minus 6. Therefore, we can write 4P cube upon 27 is equal to 32 into 10 to the power minus 6, or P cube is equal to 32 into 10 to the power minus 6 into 27 upon 4, or P cube is equal to P equal to 8 into 10 to the power minus 6 into 27 or P equal to 2 into 3 into 10 to the power minus 6, that is 6 into 10 to the power minus 6 atmosphere. That becomes the answer of the question. So thus we can apply law of mass action to a heterogeneous equilibrium, get the proper expression for Kp and Kc, and the numericals can be solved likewise. Now we will discuss another article, that is calculation of degree of dissociation with the help of vapor density. For that, first of all, we must understand what do you mean by vapor density. Vapor density, as you know, is half of the molecular weight for a substance. It is also defined as the ratio of the mass of the given gas upon mass of hydrogen under similar conditions of pressure, temperature and volume. Therefore, for those substances which undergo dissociation upon heating, this method of measuring vapor density becomes a convenient tool for finding out their degree of dissociation. Let us see how this calculation can be done. N molecules, a gaseous substance A dissociating into N molecules of B, like PCl5 dissociating into PCl3 and Cl2, ammonia dissociating into nitrogen and hydrogen, sulfur trioxide dissociating into SO2 and O2, likewise. So suppose we start our work with A moles of reactant. In the beginning, there were no moles of the product. At equilibrium, this becomes A minus X. Obviously, the number of moles of B will be NX. That is at equilibrium state. Therefore, degree of dissociation alpha will be equal to x upon A. Out of A moles of the reactant, x moles have undergone dissociation. Therefore, alpha becomes x upon A. And the total number of moles at equilibrium becomes A minus x plus nx. Further, since we know that vapor density is directly proportional to 1 upon number of moles, we can say that dT, that is the theoretical vapor density, will be proportional to 1 upon A, because we have started our work with A moles of the reactant. And similarly, dO, that is the observed vapor density, whose value is bound to be less than dT, that will be proportional to 1 upon A minus x plus nx. Dividing these two expressions,